Erica and Tina Campbell are in for more hallelujahs and headaches on the season 2 premiere of Mary Mary. In season 1, constant disagreements had fans wondering if the duo would survive. Well, they did, but the question is, for how long? This season, Erica does venture out solo while pregnant Tina gets some much-needed rest. And their manager, Mitch, tries to handle it all, but missteps into Google shoes. Oh, the drama. You're in for another emotional roller coaster ride in season 2 of Mary Mary. I caught up with the ladies to talk about their fans' reaction to season 1 and what we can expect this time around.
I wanted to get started by first congratulating you on the Mary Mary series. It's been such a ratings hit, so congratulations to you all for that. And that's the first thing we want to talk about, because I've seen some of the previews, and I know that for the first season, it was riveting. People really tuned in, and I saw a lot of activity discussing the various things that whatever the show was about. People talked about those issues you might have encountered online quite a bit. And so based off of that feedback, I'm expecting people are going to be talking, and there may be a little bit of controversy about the wedding and the strippers that are going to be on the show. How do you respond to critics who may think that that's a little too worldly for a Christian lifestyle?
I don't live my. I mean, I. This may sound. There's really no nice way to say it. It's my life. It's my family. It's our truth. And my sister was getting married. There was nothing rude or crude. Of course, when you see it on TV, a clip, and you're not sure, people's minds are left to kind of wonder and, you know, create whatever they think happened. We had a lot of fun and a great time. And, you know, glad that we were able to have a great bachelorette party for my sister. We don't really take the time to respond to the critics that much, because we'd be talking about something every single day.
Sure.
About everything. When there is something that genuinely hurts people, or something that genuinely will cause people to go, wow, you know, then I'll respond to that. Because I saw some of the messages and I saw some of the stuff, but I didn't pay that much attention to it. It is what it is. When you open up the cameras to your life, we wanted it true show. We didn't want a fake show. I didn't want to just have this party where we were sitting out eating crumpets and tea. That's not what it was. My
sister sure
was married. You know, she was a virgin, so we teased her about sex and played and laughed and had a good time. And, you know, the same thing that any family would do, I believe. And everybody that was there grew up in my church with me. Like, they're all church girls. Every single one of them.
And that's probably part of what people are seeing, Erica, is that group dynamic, because you all are a very close-knit group. And maybe that's what people need to hear. But I just wanted to ask you about that, because I saw quite a bit of conversation around it. The other thing that I wanted to talk to you about is, why reality TV? It seems like your lives were fairly open. You've been very transparent as artists. Why did you decide to go the reality TV route?
It was our opportunity to let our lives be a witness. I think people had a lot of misconceptions about what Christian life looked like. It was not just ridicule from church people. It was opinions from people who were unchurched. And their only version of what a Christian life looked like was their grandmother. So they just couldn't fathom young, good-looking, married, having a good time, women that are, you know, viable in the music business who also have a good time. A lot of people equate Christianity with boredom or a senior citizen's home or my life is over, okay, I can't do anything else, okay, all right, now I'll go to church. A lot of people still think that way. And so I think you can tell people how to live a life that reflects God, and then you can show them. Because I think there are a lot of things that people see. They see two women who are married who are truly submitted wives. We are committed to forgiveness and being honest with each other and loving our sisters. We're not selfish. We're not fighting. We're not It's not craziness like that. It's sure. a real family who loves each other and who cares about each other. My sisters and my mom and my dad and my children. And I think it's good to see. I don't think we've had seen a black family this way on TV. We've seen a lot of others.
I think you're right. Yeah, it's very refreshing, actually, in my opinion. I think it's very different, and we definitely broke the mold as a Christian group, exposing your lives in this way. So I think you're absolutely right from what I'm seeing. But then, of course, you always will have your critics. Now, in terms of, you mentioned marriage, you both have two husbands who work in the business. They work together as well. And it sometimes seems like they have a difference in opinion on your careers. Is that a correct perception?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Oh, hey, yeah, our husbands, well, first of all, they have been musicians their entire life. They're very skilled at what they do. These are musicians, producers, you know, music directors and that kind of thing. So first of all, they come in with a certain amount of knowledge and awareness of what we do and how it can be better and how it's perceived from an outside perspective, not just from a fan or consumer perspective, but from someone who actually is in the business and someone who is actually part of greater, you know, larger entities that put these presentations together. So when they're able to speak to, you know, a look or a musical presentation or how we can do things to make what we do better or make career choices, I think that first of all, it's coming from a place of not only concern, but wanting to help build and better what we do. And then they can actually speak to it because their information is credible because of what they do and who they've done it with and because of just their resumes and their natural ability. So we don't always agree with their input. Sometimes, you know, ultimately we might go with what we think is best, but we definitely do value their advice. We do listen to them. Again, every time we don't agree, but we listen to them, and their words count and matter a lot because we know that they know what they're talking about. And generally, the information that they give enhances what we do in some way or another. So it's great to have husbands who are in this business, who understand it, and who can help us to become better at what we do.
Well, one of the things that's being showcased in front of the entire nation is your motherhood. And both of you have been pregnant on camera. And in both instances, your husband showed great concern, like they wanted you to come off the road. And it also gave us, as fans, gave some concern to if you possibly were going to split as a group, not just because of motherhood, but because of the strenuous lifestyle and activity around being megastars. Can you tell fans if you are going to remain together as a group in this coming season?
They're going to have to watch the season to find that out.
Oh, come on. You got to give us a little something.
Well, you know what I'll tell you? I'll tell you this, that it is very challenging having two very filled lives that are very individualized. That our lives, we don't have a life of Mary Mary. We have a life of Erica and Tina and our husbands and our homes, and they're very, you know, they're very different. So, you know, it can be very challenging trying to maintain, you know, one unit that's almost like a marriage when we already married at home. You know what I'm saying? So it's hard. And, you know, a lot of times we want to stick it out, and then we realize maybe we shouldn't. What I will tell you is we do realize that what we have with Mary Mary is special, and it's not the same apart. But okay. We do also have challenges trying to maintain. So, again, you have to watch the season.
Okay. Well, Erica, what do you have to say?
I agree with that. She's telling, she's talking right. There's a lot of ups and downs. There's a lot of things going on. And you were asking before, you were talking about the fact that sometimes our husbands have differing opinions. They're not married to Mary Mary, they're married to Erica and Tina. And so as we run our houses, sometimes the decisions and choices and conversations that we have when me and Tina have them together, sometimes they don't always work out, you know, in the favor of Mary Mary. So, you know, it's still our lives. It's our ministry and our career, but it's our lives. It's a lot to juggle, a lot to decide. Sometimes it works out, and sometimes it doesn't. I will say this, change is coming.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How How's it working with Mitch?
Say it again.
How is it working with Mitch? He seems to have an interesting personality and management style. What's it been like working with him?
I'm sorry, Mitch is a really passionate guy, and he's really intense. And once you understand how a person is driven and kind of how they're wired and how they do what they do, then, you know, it allows the relationship to flourish, the business relationship to grow, and you get where you need to be. He's a great manager. I know a lot of people watch him on the show, and, you know, maybe his opinions of Goo or whatever, you know, the way he is about the Mary and his opinion. One thing we know for sure, he's definitely passionate about the Mary. When we started this relationship, it wasn't because we were seeking him out and trying to find him. He kind of came to us via Donald Lawrence, and it's worked out. And, you know, when you have somebody that's intense that way, it serves a purpose, because in this business, you hear a whole lot of no's. So you need somebody that's really driven, that doesn't take no for an answer, that is aggressive and believes in, you know, the artist, and he's that guy.
And puts light to your vision.
Has Mitch's relationship with Goo put any strain on your relationship with him, or either Goo? How has their relationship affected your relationship with them?
This is Tina. What I will say is we're very good at separating professional and personal. Mitch understands the boundaries that we have personally, because Google is our sister. There's a certain amount of protection that is going to come with her because she is our sister. But when it comes to the business of Mary Mary, we expect Mitch to manage our entire careers. And that applies to everybody that is a part of our career. There's certain things that only come from Erica and I, but there's a lot of elements of our career that is going to be managed by our manager. So when it comes to managing, do what you have to do to get the best for your talent. But don't cross her personally, because that's my personal sister, and then I'm going to have a personal problem with you. So managing that is a little bit crazy and a little bit tricky, but we all understand what it is. So we don't take their relationship personal, because it's not a personal attack. It's a professional arrangement. Mitch just knows when his boundaries have come into place and when to back off. And Gugu also knows when her boundaries as a sister have come to play, when to back off as somebody who's hired by Mary Mary and who has to deal with their manager. So it's a constant task, but we manage to maintain the relationship and get the best out of all parts without taking it personal.
WE TV premieres 13 brand new episodes of Mary Mary on December 6th at a special time, 10, 9 Eastern Central. I'm Mona Austin with your slice of entertainment news.